My husband and I would probably sleep a lot better if we didn't have to worry about the fact that Alzheimer's is lurking there in the future for our son, Peter.
Peter is an actor and activist living a dynamic life, and he also has Down syndrome. This is one of the most common genetic conditions, affecting one out of every 700 babies in the US. Almost everyone with Down syndrome will develop Alzheimer's disease if they live into their 60s. That means people with Down syndrome get diagnosed with Alzheimer's about 20 years earlier than the general population. There's no cure for Alzheimer's for any of the 6.7 million Americans who have it, and people with Down syndrome have been excluded from some of the clinical trials. That's why we want to study the brain's immune system in people with Down syndrome, to first understand why they're so vulnerable to Alzheimer's, and then to work to delay or prevent it altogether.
We don't understand how Alzheimer's develops, and we understand even less about how and why individuals with Down syndrome convert to Alzheimer's. So this is a ripe opportunity for informing on both conditions.
We all have immune cells in our brain, and when you get Alzheimer's, these cells act differently, but we don't know why. And we also don't know how these cells behave in people with Down syndrome. Because we can't just pull cells from the depths of our brain, we'll create our own. We'll get blood samples from adults with and without Down syndrome. Then we'll have them transformed into the brain's immune cells. Next, we'll compare the two sets of samples to uncover any differences in behavior. We'll try to figure out what causes these changes in the brain. Understanding that might help us come up with treatments and cures for Alzheimer's that would benefit everyone.
I cannot tell you how much it means to me that my extra chromosome might lead to the answer to Alzheimer's. It is quite likely that this thief will steal my memories, my very life, from me.
I want this Alzheimer's to end now.